What's up, guys? Welcome back to another video. Today, I'm going to be playing Game 4 of the NBA Finals, Raptors-Warriors. If you've been paying attention, the Raptors won that game 105-92. So, we'll be playing NBA 2K19, but before we begin, please drop a like and subscribe to my channel. Comment below. Here we go.
And David Aldridge will be joining us on the sideline as well. You take a look at the Warriors. So off the tip, it's Toronto. We got a chance here to set the floor, courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go for this one.
I am setting the floor for the Raptors.
Kyle Lowry and Danny Green are the guards in. Then there's Kawhi Leonard, and it's Marc Gasol, and it's Siakam in at the four-man position. And so Lowry will bring it up for the Toronto Raptors. Over in the corner, Green, it's tipped. Here's Thompson. To the paint, here's Cousins. That's in, coming off the assist from Thompson. Cousins has got the first points on the scoreboard for the Warriors. Klay Thompson came into this NBA with a well-earned reputation as a shooter, Brent, but did you ever think he'd become such a potent defender?
I think it's something that he's worked very hard on, and his ability to cross-match. In the early part of his career, you know, Klay Thompson had to take the better scoring of the guards on those nights. It's shifted back, and Klay Thompson is a more well-rounded understanding, not only of what he can do defensively, but more of what the opponents that he faces on a nightly basis are trying to do against him.
And here is Curry, following Kyle Lowry's three, and that one's good, Cousins.
There's a lot of great things to say about DeMarcus Cousins' offensive game, but I know defenders fear the most when he's down low and picks an angle to attack you like that in the paint.
Lowry for three. It's hauled in by Andre Iguodala. The Warriors have gone 3 of 4 from the field to start out the game. Curry with a wide open look, and a miss there on the triple. The Raptors have gone 2 for 4 from the field so far. And the rejection by Cousins. Iguodala gets to Green. And there are the Warriors now with another bucket.
That stroke looked pretty good, and solid results as Draymond knocks down a rare mid-range jumper.
Lowry drives in. Basket good. Lowry's got 8.
Shots are just flowing. Him right now having a really strong quarter.
And the wide open shot from Green gets the front of the rim and out. Toronto's gone 2 of 4 from beyond the arc to start the game. That bucket in no time at all. 10 points for him.
Well, the O looks unstoppable tonight, especially because of that guy. He's just torching them.
Feeds it to Cousins. Shoots. He makes another one. That's 4 up and 4 in to start his game.
How about he has yet to miss 4 of 4 on the start?
Here's Siakam. Off the mark there with the 3-point shot. And here's Cousins. He'll bring it up for the Golden State Warriors. Need to bounce back from Wednesday's loss.
And unfortunately for them, they just ran into a hot shooting team and really had no answer.
But this is what happens when you take nothing away defensively. Just too inactive in this game on that end of the floor.
And somebody throw some cold water on Lowry. The man is on fire. He has taken this game over. It doesn't look like he has any plans on slowing down.
Here is Livingston. Oh, and here we go. Green's got it. The fast break chance. Here's Gasol, backed in off the glass. Gasol's got his first points of the night.
Well, he's like a fumbling banker right now, dropping dimes with ease.
Kyle Lowry firing on all cylinders. One of the most demonstrative players in the game, Draymond Green.
That's all defense is. It is effort.
He should know, a former Defensive Player of the Year.
You know, he just takes pride in being their anchor defensively. And if he's not seeing that effort, he's going to let you know about it.
And welcome back to our presentation of the NBA Finals as we get going again. And from what we've seen so far from the Raptors, guys, your thoughts?
You saw it. That barrage of threes has them grooving here after one.
Well, they found a little bit of space out there on the perimeter, and they have a shared confidence right now. That tends to breed some success for this team.
Jonas Jurepko out there with Bell, and there's Livingston, and it's Cook in at the point guard. That's the group for the Golden State Warriors to start the second quarter.
And even now in his mid-30s, Marc Gasol is fantastic. I mean, he gives you everything you want at that center position. Strong defender and rebounder, and he has a host of ways to get you buckets.
And his versatility on offense is so spectacular. He always finds ways to help put points up on the board.
McKinney passes to Livingston. Misses the layup.
And he's been way off the mark this quarter. It's been ugly.
And Gasol, he continues to develop his outside shot break to act as a stretch center now.
Yeah, and really the combination of his three-ball shooting and his passing, really, even at this stage of his career, makes him a tough cover. You worry if he'll settle too much for that outside shot, but boy, when he is on, there are few answers for slowing him down.
His second shot goes in, off to a good start, 2 for 2.
And he knows how to make good use of his size in that low block. And Gasol's inside game is very refined. There's a smoothness to how he approaches it.
And the foul called on Kenny Green. That's his first foul. .124 left in the first half. Pass to Siakam. Toronto working the ball around now. Here's Lowry. There's the basket and making a double-digit lead. Lowry's got 15.
Now he's a heady player. He knows how to get himself going and giving his team a real advantage right now on the offensive end.
And the Warriors decide to take their first time out here. And Marc Gasol, a force on both ends of the floor. You forget, you know, Greg, that he's won a Defensive Player of the Year award.
Yeah, you know, Gasol doesn't really wow you on defense with what he does. I mean, he gets blocks, but it's really his positioning and his rotations are what make him so great. Always involved in plays, and he just seems to be able to protect the rim and a terrific team defender.
DeMarcus Cousins is checked in for Bell, and it's in there. Siakam's got his second basket of the night.
Oh, great ball movement there.
They've been looking out of sync offensively.
Yeah, their offense has ground to a standstill.
Steph out there singing a lullaby to the defense, gets them to sleep, and then sets up the teammate nicely.
And you could tell he thought that triple was going to fall.
It's hauled in by the Raptors. 32 seconds left here in the second. Green inside the three-point line. Rebound by DeMarcus Cousins. Warriors trail by 10. A shot by Thompson. No one's around. Offline with his three. Here's Gasol. Down it goes for his third basket in as many tries.
Up by a bunch. He's still pushing the action, trying to impose his will.
Well, collectively, they've done it tonight here. A passionate performance from the squad.
Three-pointer, Lowry. It doesn't go for him. And so is Toronto. Enjoying a 20.
Thank you, Kevin. Kyle, a good first half for you all. How do you continue?
Thanks, David. And we'll be back shortly following halftime to get the third quarter under.
And now, the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hello, everyone. For the Raptors, Shaq, what was your takeaway on Toronto?
You got to like their offense efficiency. They were patient, took good shots. That was reflected in their high field goal percentage. They just need to keep playing smart in the second half and close this thing.
And it's just about time now.
Oh, look there at the Golden Gate Bridge, blanketed, shrouded. And fog, what a sight. Welcome back to the Bay Area, everyone. Welcome back to game 4 as we get back into the action. Kyle Lowry has just been sensational.
Yeah, good things happen when you maintain composure. Their shot selection has been extremely disciplined.
Greg, is there a shot that he's taken that has been out of the flow of the offense? I don't think so.
So the Raptors 5 right now. Kyle Lowry and Danny Green are the guards in. It's Marc Gasol. Then there's Kawhi Leonard. And it's Siakam in at the four. And he gets it back. And yes, it's good. Green's got it back down to a single-digit deficit for the Warriors.
Yeah, just tireless from Draymond that time. The guy used each possession and creates a second opportunity that time.
Shots good by Green. When you look at the new requirements of the center, who really stands out as the prototypical pivot man?
Wow, I really think that Porzingis has shown some signs in the last two seasons. Now, it's been cut short. The first season, he really faltered in the second half of the year. And then last year, a devastating injury that's going to keep him out for quite some time. But some of the things that he's been able to show have me very intrigued about the potential of that position. Now, I know more guys like Clint Capella and the impact he had in Houston has been phenomenal. But Porzingis and that overall package still has me really intrigued, Kevin.
7'3", he becomes a very interesting subject.
He does, and that ability to shoot the basketball as well. Just think about it. When he plays with a qualified point guard to set some action up, could be dangerous.
Lowry gets to Leonard. That falls. Nice feed that time from Kyle Lowry. Lowry's got 3 assists in the game. And there's the call on Kyle Lowry. That's his 4th foul of the contest.
I don't know if you push the panic button now, but that's the 4th personal. And he needs to stay aggressive out there. So it's going to be interesting to see how he plays moving forward.
And the Warriors making a change here. Bell's checked in. And it's Leonard missing.
And forcing the miss there. He just knows how to pressure you defensively.
You hear a lot about rim protection. This is a good example of how valuable it can be. The defense looked lost there. Hit out your compass. No excuses. You got to guard the perimeter. Well, the Warriors returning to San Francisco next season after 48 years in Oakland. That new arena in Mission Bay getting finished up, polished up, fresh paint. It's looking good there. And hopefully it'll be just as rocking as Oracle Arena has been for this many years.
Let's take this chance now to show you the list of the postseason scoring leaders. Second is Kawhi Leonard. Steph Curry, 4th.
And whether it's been attacking off the bounce or pulling up, both these guys have been lighting it up.
Livingston kicks the bell. Branson wondered whether they changed their name to the San Francisco Warriors. Well, like before, they're going to stick with Golden State.
Yeah, too much history, I think, in Oakland. They don't want to do anything to disturb the fan base. This is the Bay Area's team, and you mentioned it. It does have a history, Kevin, starting off back in San Francisco in the 60s, and they've become a powerhouse. It seems even more fitting to claim the entire state, the Golden State Warriors.
And Bell is on a mission to show how special he can be, an athletic, energetic forward who plays with a real passion.
Now, here's Cousins. 12 points for him. Now, here's Livingston, guarded by Green. Offensive rebound, fires the 3, and the Warriors miss again. Toronto leading by 13. Leonard dishes to Lowry. From the arc, and the shot goes in from Siakam. Siakam's got 11.
Yeah, that's too good a look to give him from behind the arc.
Just 2 seconds between shot clock and game clock. Here is Cook. Now recovering, Jurepko kicks to Cook. Some nice passing by Golden State. 6 on the shot clock. Here's Livingston. And he's fouled pretty hard on that shot, but he's got the chance to pick up the points at the line. It's on Kawhi Leonard.
Well, DeMarcus Cousins is so aggressive, he's always going to draw some fouls on the inside. Whether the refs call that or not, fortunately for the team, he's a very good free throw shooter.
And he's good on the second. 3 minutes gone now in the third quarter. From deep. And no good. And so it's the Toronto Raptors. Their lead at 15 going into the break. The one goal they had coming into this game was to not let Curry beat them. And so far. How about a look at today's State Farm assist of the game?
And the winner today, the big fella here with the sweetest of dimes.
what a plus it is to have a post player who's got this ability to fire.
You know, anytime a guy's in the post and the teammates know he's unselfish, great player movement can create an opportunity just like that.
And we reach the fourth quarter in a game that may be already out of hand. Curry and Thompson are the one and the two. Down low, it's Green and Cousins. And it's Iguodala at the small forward position. That's the Warriors' five. And here's Gasol. He'll bring it up for the Toronto Raptors. Green finds Leonard. Outside Lowry. Brent, as we take a look at lineups around the NBA, teams trying to go with five highly skilled players at once. Where does that leave the traditional big?
Well, most teams just don't have one now, Taylor. I mean, they're just not on the roster.
Hard to find, yeah.
Well, they're hard to find, but there just aren't many out there. So a lot of teams just elect not to have one. And what we're seeing over the course of the last couple of years is the matchups when all of a sudden a Whiteside is going to see a Drummond, or you're going to see all of a sudden Valanciunas play against DeAndre Jordan. It's usually because you have one, we'll play ours kind of mentality.
And you can see the play calling this half, another one from distance.
And no question, it looks like they've rented out room along the perimeter in this ball game, and they're likely to keep doing this until the defense makes an adjustment.
A little over a minute of the fourth quarter gone right now. Curry kicks to Thompson. Curry against Lowry. Curry's shot is off. Raptors leading by 16. Pass to Gasol. Back to Lowry. 1:31 left to play in the final quarter. Green passes to Lowry. Down to five on the shot clock. There's the three. The shot off that time. The Warriors go the other way.
And hold on to your hats, folks. This has been a whirlwind championship finals thus far. Obviously an important hard-fought victory tonight for Toronto.
The differential in assists led to a lot of open looks and also helped to get more guys involved in the offense easy.
And they made the defense adjust, but they just couldn't come up with an answer.
Gasol kicks to Siakam. Good, and the assist goes to Gasol.
Yeah, with this lead, that's probably going to do it. Fans heading for the exits.
Now the team came in fired up from the opening tip. To see the focus.
Already, please drop a like
to do
this video. Subscribe to my channel on offense,
but at some point he's going to need
some
help.
Thank you for watching this video. You can watch the rest of it.
Lowry from outside.
We just got 30 seconds.
Warriors with the rebound.
35 seconds left. Thank you for watching this. This is NT Superstar.
Thompson inside the line.
Out.
Siakam pulls it in.
Not sure what the D was doing there. Clearly a breakdown. You can ill afford to give a guy like him that good a look.
Lowry can't get it to go. Here's Golden State, trailing by 17. Gasol finds Leonard. Lowry with the ball. From deep three-point range, off target. And so Toronto takes this one, but by a big margin.